Hi, I'm Dr. Randy Morris. As a physician who has dedicated his life to helping couples to conceive and deliver babies, I am always looking for new approaches to treat infertility. Fallopian tube blockage is a common cause for infertility. Today, on Infertility TV, I am going to explore the use of the supplement serapeptase for unblocking fallopian tubes. Stay tuned. Most of the time, fallopian tube blockage has no symptoms. Blockage is usually diagnosed by hysterosalpingogram, which is an x-ray performed while squirting fluid through the uterus and tubes with a catheter. Fallopian tubes can become blocked due to infections, especially sexually transmitted infections such as chlamydia or gonorrhea, endometriosis, or even surgery. IVF is a great treatment to become pregnant if you have blocked tubes, but if you don't have insurance that covers fertility problems, it is expensive. Surgery is sometimes an option, but it's very invasive and doesn't always work. In many cases, I've been able to open blocked tubes using catheters and wires, but not everybody can get to my fertility center in the USA to have this highly effective treatment. Wouldn't it be great if there was a pill you could take to open block fallopian tubes? Serapeptase is sold as a capsule or tablet. What is serapeptase? Serapeptase was first isolated in the 1960s from a rather disgusting place. It was being produced from a species of bacteria found in the intestines of caterpillars. The bacteria is called Serratia marescens. In fact, serapeptase was originally known as serrapeptase or serrapeptidase. Serapeptase is an enzyme which speeds up the breakdown of certain types of proteins. One of the hoped-for uses of serapeptase was to help break down blood clots inside blood vessels. This could be helpful for people with coronary heart disease. Takeda, a well-respected pharmaceutical company based in Japan, sold it for several years. Ultimately, they stopped selling it and recalled it about 10 years ago when studies found that it did not have any benefit. After that, some smaller companies started pushing the use of serapeptase for other indications. Blood vessels can have blockages and fallopian tubes can have blockages. So these companies started advertising serapeptase as a treatment for blocked fallopian tubes. Let's look at the evidence. I couldn't remember seeing any infertility studies being done with serapeptase. So I searched for any studies through the National Library of Medicine database. No studies on this topic were found. Next, I looked at clinicaltrials.gov, which lists many currently ongoing studies. Nothing. The Cochrane database. Nothing. Finally, I searched Google. All I could find were ads from vendors trying to sell serapeptase with claims of success and posts on social media or infertility support groups, but no actual clinical studies. When we look at how serapeptase is supposed to work, it really doesn't make any sense that it would be able to open fallopian tubes. When you digest serapeptase, if it does not get destroyed completely in the stomach, it must be absorbed from the intestines into the blood. Since it circulates in the blood, you could at least make some argument that maybe it could act on blockages within a blood vessel. But fallopian tube blockages are not inside blood vessels, they are inside the tubes. The serapeptase would have to exit the blood vessels in the fallopian tubes, concentrate itself in the tube, and somehow magically break down the blockage in the lumen of the tube without damaging the tube itself. It just doesn't seem very likely. In fact, every review I found which analyzed studies done on serapeptase for other indications found that existing scientific evidence for serapeptase is insufficient to support its use as a health supplement. What can I say? There is absolutely no evidence that serapeptase works to unblock fallopian tubes. There is no reason to even suspect that serapeptase could open fallopian tubes. Is there any harm to trying? In this case, I would say yes. First is the cost. This stuff is not cheap. The average cost was between $25 and $60 per bottle. One post on Facebook said that women would need to take 6 months or longer for it to work. Second, adverse reactions. With short-term use, most people taking serapeptase were not severely harmed. However, serapeptase has been found to cause a number of serious medical problems in some people, such as eosinophilic pneumonitis, bullous pemphigoid, bleeding, and a severe drug reaction known as Stevens-Johnson syndrome. Most of the studies looked at serapeptase use for only a few weeks. The effects from longer-term use are completely unknown. Our Infertility TV bottom line for serapeptase is this. There is no proven benefit and there are potential risks. Do not take serapeptase to try to open fallopian tubes. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. You can also check us out on our website at IVF1.com, where you can register to become a patient.